Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to review for you guys the latest palette from Menagerie Cosmetics, the Sugar High. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 46 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. If you want to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, if you feel you're not old but vintage, and if you are slightly orcish like me, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. I don't think I have to explain the vintage, right? You know what? Vintage is in fashion. So, apparently I am in fashion. Very, very nice. Never mind. I will explain the slightly orcish. It means green. I am a light warm olive. I'm not extremely warm. I'm on the warmer side of medium. That's kind of it. I fall in between a rock and a hard place. No, I don't. But that's neither here nor there. The Sugar palette from, or the Sugar High palette from Menagerie Cosmetics. So it's a very, very cute artwork. Sugar gliders. The palette is vegan and cruelty free. You get 12 shades. And it is a combination of mattes and shimmers. The pans are removable because the palette is magnetic. And in today's video, I will show you three looks. At the end of the video, I will tell you if I am happy that I gave Menagerie Cosmetics another chance, or if this is basically the last time that I will try them. You will have to wait for the ending of the video. For now though, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. I am going to start with the shade called Yogurt Drop. My base is still sticky. I'm going to put this in here. I hope that my focus is okay. I put it on manual today to experiment a little bit, so I hope it's okay. I'm going next to the shade Sweet Varieties. It's going to go on the outside of my eye, from the bottom lid up. Then I'm going to place it, and then it's going to go in. And I'm tapping the shadow on, and then here I'm basically kind of flicking it forward a little bit into the purpley shade. I'm following my eyeball. Kind of going back and forth. I'm blending the edges a bit. Also want it underneath my eye. I'm going to go back to the shade Yogurt Drop. Just going to intensify it a little bit. Kind of blend it a little bit in the outer corner. But I kind of like the graphic, kind of graphic-y look that I have going there. Okay. It's time for the shimmers. And I am going to grab for one eye my jelly primer. That is, this one is from Death and Candy. And how do I use it? I grab a brush that I want to use for my shimmers. I grab, it's clean, and I grab a little bit of the jelly primer out of the pot on the back of my hand. And then distribute it on my brush a bit. And then I'm going to tap it on my lid. That's basically, I'm sandwiching this between the shimmer shade and the matte that I have on my lid. I'm just tapping it on. Okay. Making sure that it's not too wet. So I'm cleaning it, wiping it on a towel. And then I'm going to go into shade Falling with Style. And I'm going to press this on. Oh, that's pretty. I'm just going to make sure that the primer is all saturated. Very, very pretty. Okay. I am going to grab a smaller brush for the inner eye part area. And I'm going to go to the shade Sugar Cube. I'm going to brush it over that tealy a little bit. And then I'm going to grab that shade Falling with Style again, the tealy. And I'm kind of going to brush it over here in the beginning. I'm going to go back to Sugar Cube. Cute. I also want it underneath my eye, and I'm grabbing a little bit of the jelly primer again. with a very, very small brush. And I'm going to do this on both eyes. So for both my bottom lids, I'm going to do this method. I'm just pressing it on. This side I'm going to basically finish the same way, but I'm not going to use a jelly primer. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to grab the shadow Falling with Style and I'm going to spray it, and then I'm going to put it on my eye. So I load up my brush first, then I'm going to spray the brush with, I don't know, a setting spray or whatever you have. A bit of water is fine as well. Tap off the loose particles. And then basically doing the same thing. And the reason that I'm doing one side with the primer and one side without is because I want to see if it will crease for me. I am going to finish off the look and I'll be right back. I finished off the look with Falsies from AOA Studio in the style Jean. Lippy is from Colourpop, lip liner in BFF, and liquid lipstick from Lethal Cosmetics in the shade Departure. Eye pencil is from Glam Shop in the shade, what is it? Milky pink? Pink milk, yes. Eyeliner on top is from the palette. I just scraped out a little bit of the shade Yogurt Drip and then a little bit of mixing medium, and that is the liner. And then this is how the look turned out, and I really, really like it. Let me know down below what you think of it. Let's get ready for look number two. Okay, I am going to start with the shade Joey. I'm switching brushes. I also want it underneath my eye and then connect it up. I'm grabbing a pencil brush, the shade Joey, and then I'm going to spray the shade, same as if I would use a shimmer. This makes it more intense, especially if you have already set your under eye. It also makes sure that the matte shade stays in place more. However, if you want to build it up, you kind of need to dry your brush off in between, so don't go in the shade with a wet brush. That's not good for the shade, unless it's loose. It's a loose formula, then you can. I'm grabbing a fluffier brush. I'm just going to go over the top layer to make sure that the color is nice and even. Okay, now I'm going to go to the shade called Slice. And it's going to go in the outer corner and the lower crease. Now this is kind of a neon-y shade, so let's see how it will behave, because a lot of the time neons don't really want to layer or blend. But it looks like this one does. Now I did keep the bottom crease kind of bare of shadow, so there is that. I like this. I'm just going to really pack it on in the outer corner and the crease. And because I already have a layer underneath when I basically place it and I swipe it forward, it kind of blends itself already. Especially with this shade underneath. I am going to tap with a little bit of the shade, tap over the border. So not really blending, but kind of tapping it into place a bit. Okay, back to the brush that was a little bit more open. I'm just slightly going to blend the edge. And then I'm going to grab a little bit of the shade Joey. And I'm going to blend it over. But again, just concentrating on the edge. And then I'm grabbing a little bit of Slice. And I'm blending or kind of placing that a little bit higher. I'm going to grab my glitter primer. I'm using that jelly again. Same thing as yesterday. Tapping it on my lid. And I'm going to go to Pouch Protective. And that's going to go all over my lid. Oh my lord. Oh, this color makes me extremely happy. I also want this underneath my eye. And I'm going to use the jelly primer there as well. Oh, I kind of want to bathe in this color. Oh, oh. Okay, I'm going to go back to the shade Slice for the outer corner. And I'm just going to really basically pack that on top a bit. I'm really looking down and I'm just going to go over the border of the shimmer shade. Nice. Then I'm going to go back to the shade Joey. Okay. Oh, I really, really like this. However, I also have a very, very cool green. What am I going to do with that? Well, that's going to go in the inner corner. Yes. I'm going to finish off that eye. Think of an eye pencil. I don't know if I want an orange or green. And then finish off the rest and I'll be right back. I finished off the look with falsies from Unearthly Cosmetics in the style Dreamlike. For my eyeliner, I also use an Unearthly gel liner in the shade Squash. For eye pencil, I kind of went Frankenpencil again. I grabbed the Glam Shop long lasting one in coral and kind of topped it off a little bit with one from NYX, an Epic Wear liner stick in Orangey Zest to get a little bit of a sparkle. On my lips is a lipstick from Lethal Cosmetics in the shade Quest. That's it. And I really like how it turned out. I feel very, very nice and summery, which is good because it's very nice weather outside today. So let me know down below what you think of this look and let's get ready for look number 3. I am going to start with the shade called Snugglebug. Yes. I just blended out the edges and that worked very, very well. Very, very cutesy. I want to brighten that shade up, so I'm going to go to a smaller brush. And I'm just placing it a little bit lower, just a hint lower, and then blend the edges in. Next, I'm going to go to the shade called Furry Friend, and I'm going to deepen up the outer corner and the crease. So I'm going to use a jelly primer again. I'm going to put that on both eyes and then I'm going to start with the shimmer called Ruby. Okay, so this is, it has more yellow in it. I don't want to say it's a neutral red. It looks to be a little bit of a warmer red. And what I mean by that is that there's more yellow in it than blue. Okay, I am going to go back to the shade Furry Friend for the crease to blend a little bit on top of that shimmer red as well. Then I'm going to go back to the first shade and kind of blend that in there too. So an eye pencil I have is one from LA Girl. It's a Shockwave. Well, it's technically a lip pencil, I actually think. So what I also want to do is I also want to do that red shimmer on my bottom lid. So I'm going to use the jelly primer first. Tap it on and then I'm going to add that shimmer on top. Inner corner highlight is, or inner corner, I'm grabbing a brush and again the jelly primer. It just makes shadows stay so nicely for me that I just really like to use this. I'm going to go to the shade Sugary Sweet. And I'm kind of going to blend it a little bit in the inner corner area on my lid. So then for the inner corner, I'm going to go to the shade Sugar Cube. Wow. I'm going to finish everything off and I'll be right back.
back.
I finished off the look with half lashes from Veve in the style HL2. Eye pencil I already mentioned. And the lippy is a combination between a Kaleidos lip clay in the shade Smeared Rouge, which I kind of blotted a little bit. And then I put a little bit of the shade the Gloss Bitchcraft from Luna Beauty on top to get it to be a little bit shiny and juicy and such. Yes, I really do like how this look turned out on. I think it's very, for me, it's very, very unique. And it's not something that I have done before, but I do really, really like it. It makes a bold statement, to say the least. Yes, let me give you my thoughts on this palette. Let's start with the way that it looks on the outside. It's the cute factor is through the roof, right? It's so extremely, extremely cute. The palette is a little bit smaller than I thought initially. When I saw the pictures, I thought the palette was a little bit bigger. But yeah, that's kind of what she said, isn't it? I thought it was bigger. Never mind. But the outside looks extremely cute. I also love the fact that on the box, let me get the box. There's just a different, you know, you have a peek of the sugar glider. And then here you have it in all its glory. And then you open her up. And it's basically what I expect to see on the outside is reflected on the inside. Here you have some more muted shades and then here you have the brighter shades. And then the combination between the mattes and the shimmers, I personally really, really enjoy. And I think for me, on a warmer skin tone, especially a warmer olive skin tone, works very, very well. If you are warmer than me, especially olive-wise, I think this will agree with you too. If you are a cool-toned light olive though, go check out my bestie Debbie, because she also got this palette and she's a cool tone olive. And when she swatched some of especially these shades, they were kind of a little bit, for her particular skin tone, she felt not really flattering. So I will leave her channel down below. I know she has the palette. I don't know when she will upload a video with that, but just keep her channel in mind. Just subscribe because she's awesome. And then you can see this used on a light, basically my depth, but then a cool toned olive. Let's go to the performance then. For me, the shadows performed extremely well. I could layer them, I could blend them, especially these two, which are neon brighter neon shades. And sometimes, or actually a lot of the time, they are a little bit more difficult to layer and you kind of need to work with them a special way. But I did not feel that I needed to in this at all. Oh yeah, creasing. Let me tell you about the creasing. I had no creasing except with this shade. And the creasing was very, very, very minimal. I had to kind of look for it. Now, why do I say that these types of shades and orange shimmers and then these, while I love them with a passion, they tend to kind of crackle on me. And that's it. These did not. Yeah, this one did a hint, but that was at the end of the day. Overall, I am very, very happy that I tried Menagerie Cosmetics again. Now, I'm not going to go in it too much in this video, but I basically took a break from the brand because of the way that things were for international shipping, for international customers, also how the palettes came packaged. This time though, I had no complaints whatsoever. The palette was packaged extremely well. It was in a box and not in a bubble wrap envelope. And it was just, nothing happened. Nothing happened. I also feel that this is a different formula than what I tried from the Feral and the pastel palette, the pastel pop that I used to have. I feel that these shadows are more up my alley. They are still pigmented, but they are not as dry. They're easy to work with. You can layer, you can blend. I do want to say that if you want to do kind of a lighter pastel-y look, but I say that always, use a base that has a little bit more stick. So the one that I use in this video is a Natasha Denona base in the shade Light. And it still has stick, but not as much stick as I would prefer if I really want to pack on a pastel shade. But I still could get it to show up for me. So if you are fair, all the shadows will show up for you. If you are deeper, I think they will as well. If you have this palette and you are of a darker skin tone, let me know down below how you like it. I like this formula of Menagerie Cosmetics a lot. If you are in the US, I would definitely recommend it. If you are an international customer, I still recommend this, but just be mindful that it will be twice as expensive. And that is the downside of being an international customer, especially in the EU, because the EU is just effing us around. So I kind of hope that there will come a time when especially smaller indie brands are just able to give us shipping options. And that's for us here as well, right? That brands just can give us some better rates internationally. Because yeah, at the end of the day, this palette was twice as expensive for me. But I'm still very, very happy that I have it in my collection. Let me know if you got this palette. Let me know your thoughts about the palette. Do you like it? Do you not like it? Do you like the looks that I did? So far, what I can say about Menagerie Cosmetics is that I'm happy that I bought this palette. The experience was very, very nice. Shipping-wise, how it was packaged. It came here very, very quickly as well. I think it was here within 2 weeks or something, which is extremely quick. And I really, really like this formula of them as well. This is, from what I've tried from them, my favorite formula. And I hope that is helpful. And then this is going to be it for today. Let me know your thoughts down below. And let me also know if you have a favorite look. I don't really have a favorite look, I feel, but this one makes me feel extra fierce. So there is that. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very, very soon for my next video. Bye, guys.